diary. As many players have already heard, the next hall event coming to the English server on December 15th is Time Palace, aka 4 Stories. Now, I have spent 21,000 diamonds on this event so that you may not necessarily have to, and I have been waiting for this day to show you how every single suit and every background from this event actually works in-game, plus tips and tricks you probably never heard of, and the beautiful, beautiful stories. If you're already familiar with the suits, skip ahead to 6:30 or so for the super, super rare items, top scoring estimates, tips, and stories. So if you missed my first video on this event, here's a lightning fast recap. It's basically the cousin of the Art of War event we had earlier, where we sacrifice our firstborn, I mean our diamonds, to the Great Event Pavilion and do pulls. Each pull has a chance of giving us a closing item, or stamina, gold, or diamonds back. We'll talk about the probabilities of each in the second half of the video for players who like numbers. In the meantime, let's see why this event has been hailed as one of the most creative and best valued in the game's history. The first reason is that each milestone of this event gives you not one, but multiple suits. Right now, we're looking at the first suit from what is called the Gift of the Magi pair, a super adorable schoolgirl with a crying makeup that's different from all the crying makeups we have in-game, and plenty of versatile items that can be mixed and matched with anything cute, preppy, or even elegant in our wardrobe. We'll also get her friend, whose hair I spam because it's just such a cute short hair and another crying makeup. But you wonder, right? They don't really look that impressive as Hell Event suits. And that is because they come with two more suits, namely their adult counterparts. If you like soft, lovely pink, you'll get it here, not to mention the developers were nice enough to separate the normal pose into a top and bottom skirt for us. And just look at the pink glory that is her violin case, plus another makeup! And if this pink looking vibe isn't your thing, the event's got you covered because we have this suit named Soul Blues rocking that more mature look. And by the way, there are also not one, but two backgrounds. All of this in a single milestone. And now, typically, I will go on to the next pair of suits at this point, but we're gonna talk about the most important thing about this event, and that is the creative aspect it brings to the game. Namely, with each of these suits, we get an accessory that's not a headdress, or necklace, or flowers, or trees, but an item in the image of a person. Meaning, you can now squeeze multiple figures into your competition or stereo corridor entries. And since there are more than one of these, we can just keep stacking them until you have more than 10 people in a single picture with your Nikki. Now, when this came out on the Chinese server, it pretty much revolutionized what people can do with their creative faculties, and I simply can't wait for our stereo corridor on the English server to do all kinds of cool and out of this world things with them. Okay, now that you heard my hype, the other suits also deserve the spotlight. We have a romantic pair next, the silent platform pair. This time, the girl suit comes with a running pose and a shouting makeup. The hair in the normal pose also has these super nice curls, and we again get a top and bottom and just so many accessories. Her counterpart is this handsome, handsome boy who looks kind of goofy without his makeup, but he's got broad shoulders still and also pigeons. So once again, a ton of items that can be used for both male and female outfits. What most players aren't aware of is also that first, there is a background, animated, and there are two versions of them. The first one has this charming boy on the string, and the second version is a fun one because you can now put your Nikki or someone else or another accessory on the train too, and they'll appear behind these railings for extra creative potential. We also have more graceful suits. This one is sitting, so it can also sit on all those other accessories we already have, and it comes with its own stone seat. Instead of a top and bottom this time, we have a dress, coat, a waist item, and even her own book. Her sister is this cute green cloud suit because we need more green in the game. She comes with an arm pose isolated to the gloves, and in a normal pose, she carries a glass jar of fireflies and has her own makeup once again. Their background is also one of my favorites in the game because there are so many things you can do with this black border-like decorative wall here, and it has animated butterflies. And finally, we have suits for the last milestone. First is the relatively casual of the two, City Subway, with a close-eyed makeup. Her coat in the normal pose is surprisingly cool looking though, and comfy. She even has an iPod and a plastic lunch bag. Don't ask me why, it's fashionable. Her other bag is red and super pretty though. Of course, we can't forget the mermaid suit. Now, I know this is not the first mermaid suit we have, but this one, we have to admit that there is a lot of work put into the details and textures of her dress. There's even a special lighting effect. And then if we go on into the normal pose, we can see that the developers put a lot of work into separating out the accessories too. And her not having a tail might actually be a good thing because I have seen her dress just used for no reason in competitions. Everyone just loves it. Now on the Chinese server, this background they came with was panoramic, but as of right now, I'm not sure if we'll get it as panoramic on the English server because we didn't get one for the Art of War event due to localization issues. For the minor suits, we'll go over them quickly because most of them are not posed. They do have recolors, and I have to say that for this sailor suit, her hair is so useful in both colors. And in case you missed Art of Wars, so when we do pulls, we can get multiple copies of these minor suit items, and then we can go to the customization menu where we normally recolor things and turn these extra items into their recolored versions. So all of these things we've seen so far cost about 9690 diamonds, and the reason why I ended up spending 21,000 something diamonds instead of 9,000 is because of these super rare / SSR items that we don't get to see every day. So, ta-da! I know they look really small, but a player is considered to have completed this event only when they have gotten these items and their recolors. That is what we refer to as true completion. They do take a ton of pulls past the last milestone though, so be careful. Now let's switch gears and talk about numbers and stats. In terms of top scoring items, I used the Chinese server to compile a rough estimate of the number of top scoring items in the main suits. As you can see here, the suits that come with the most expensive milestone actually have the least number of top scoring items. At least on the Chinese server. And even the SSR items are only okay in terms of stats. This handheld is pretty awesome though. Again, please note that this is an estimate for early bird players. Once the website ln.nikkis.info updates, I strongly recommend you heading over there and check them out by yourself. And as always, shout out and mad respect to Sweet Cupcake for creating and maintaining this insanely good website. For cost, I have seen many lovely players referencing to this cost here that I talked about in my previous video, and I just want to elaborate a bit here. So yes, the first three nodes cost 1.29k, 3.39k, and 6.39k diamonds with all the free tries. We receive random suits for these three nodes, and the last node is guaranteed to be the mermaid and subway girl suits. By the time you hit the last node at 9.69k diamonds, you'll most likely already have all of the original colors of the minor suits as well, which is why I said there that it's about 9.69k diamonds for 14 suits. Collecting all the recolors and the SSRs though requires a lot more funds. And speaking of the SSRs, we should chat about some tips and tricks. The first is that know that one copy of an SSR item drops approximately every 100 pulls. Knowing this can help you determine whether you should stop pulling or pull just a tad more. This is also why we say that full completion requires about 21k diamonds, because you need a total of 7 copies to have all the SSR items and their recolors, meaning 700 or so pulls times 30 diamonds per pull. And I know you may think that I don't really care about order percentage. It's just that from personal experience of playing on a server that's 3.5 years old, which is the age of the Chinese server, I've come to realize that most players do become completionists sooner or later. You might just suddenly like get really competitive with a friend on your friend list, or you can just get bored as time goes on and want another goal to aim for. So I do recommend players to think about that possibility thoroughly and get as early of a start as possible. Second is that don't forget this event is a 17-day event. We get a lot of free diamonds from dailies, settlements, housing, etc. for 17 days. The event itself also gives you some diamonds back, so don't fret just yet if the event seems impossible. And now get ready for my favorite time, it's story time! This event is nicknamed Four Stories after all, so what would Four Stories be without the stories? How about a love story first? So this boy's name is Leon, he's a North boy, but he lives in Lilith, and he likes this girl next to him, and she likes him back. But this girl can't speak, and our North boy is going to war because somebody, / Mr. Nitty, decided to start one. The day Leon is boarding the train for departure though, he saw the girl chasing and trying her hardest to shout something, not even caring that her hat flew away. And he tried so hard to reach out to her, yet they could not touch. But in that moment, they understood how each other felt. The girl also caught a note from Leon, which said, "Farewell, the me who loves you." And Leon, watching as her figure disappeared, thought to himself that it was not a goodbye, but a promise. A promise that they'll meet again one day. Pretty good, right? The next one is two, actually. So this is Tina and Summer, delinquent and goody-two-shoes, yet also best friends. Summer was the shy classical musician and Tina the rock star. When they first met, though, it was Summer, the fragile-looking one, who stood up against boys that were going to beat up Tina. They became friends who inspired each other, not just in life, but also in their musical journey. However, Tina had to move before she could finish the song she was writing for Summer. Years later though, Summer the violinist was the one who became a rock star instead, and Tina became the classical musician. And they each came to see the other perform, thanking each other and thinking that it must have been the gift of fate that led them to where they are. Now for the Cloud Girls. These two are sisters. They lived a hard life, even though I know their clothes look very pretty, but they couldn't even really afford proper lighting. The older sister had to make things by the dim light of the fireflies they capture and try to make the worlds of those wonderful old tales seem real for her younger sibling, so they can, you know, live easier. But the younger sister wanted to go out into the real world instead, and she soon realized that the real world is 100 times harder. But whenever she's about to break, she will remember how even though her sister was always gentle, soft-spoken, she never gave up in the face of all the hardships. So the younger sister didn't give up either, and always, always wrote back to her dear sibling, who was also determined to always be the home and the light for the other to return to. And last but not least, the Subway Girl and the Mermaid. So the real main character is a Subway Girl, whose name literally means small fish, Xiao Yu. So we'll just call her Yu Chan for now. Yu Chan lives in Welton, Apple Federation. She's taking the last subway / train home. I think she's going through a quarter life crisis because when she hears on the train that Miss Kimmy is going to represent the Apple Federation as a diplomat to the North Kingdom, she started thinking that Miss Kimmy had already accomplished so much at her age, yet it feels like Yu Chan herself has done absolutely nothing, like a pile of sand that can't turn into gold no matter how hard she tried. Then it started raining and she fell asleep. When she opened her eyes, she saw herself in a vast space of pure blue. She couldn't feel her own existence until she heard songs from the distance and realized that those were whale songs, and she herself was a whale. For a long time, she couldn't tell whether she was in a dream or she was really a whale and dreamed her existence on the train and the world above. She found other whales and started singing with them, blending in perfectly. Storms started to gather as the songs grew higher and higher, and then lightning pierced the sky and a voice said, "The train has arrived at its final destination." When Yu-chan walked out of the train though, she was full of inspirations, and outside, the stars were lighting up the rain-washed sky. And those are the forming stories of the four stories story suits. The minor suits also have stories, but since this video is already very long, let me know if you want to read them instead and I'll post them. Thank you so much again for watching. Please like and subscribe if you could spare a minute. I would really appreciate it. And let's all have a lot of fun when this event comes on Saturday. Thank you!